Yeah.
I mean, I think we're getting hard done by him because they changed it in about an hour, which is incredible. And he has been on fire. Both of these drivers have not put a foot wrong all weekend. They go in, even Stevens in terms of power, grip, you know, experience. Maybe Korpinski with a little bit more experience in terms of getting very close and onto the podiums and Driftmasters. But Kodua, he's going to chase this S14 in like there's no tomorrow.
Well, there we go. It's the Polishman, Pavel Korpinski, to lead in the Georgian driver, Nodu Kodua. They come down. You can see Nodu Kodua getting right up personal. But as Korpinski puts the power down, starts to drive away, but he's made a big error. There's a big problem with Pavel Korpinski's car. Nodu Kodua does an exceptional job of avoiding contact. They come through now. That first hairpin, they transition back into the second one. Korpinski gets that car back up and running as Kodua starts to give him some room to manoeuvre. Look, very clever. Doesn't shortcut the circuit. Stays on that qualifying line and says, I know he made the mistake. I'm going to do what I need to do. Kodua is going to finish up this run. Korpinski looking hurt.
I'm not sure what happened. Looked like he got a ton of understeer on that first corner. Looked like he could not get the car back on power again. Very uncharacteristic mistake for one of the best drivers on the grid. Korpinski making all the errors. Kodua shortcuts. I was just watching shortcutting this first corner to try and get that proximity, and he is losing ground. But there's so much speed and so much grip in Korpinski's car. Watch this. As he comes through here, all four wheels have to go straight just to stay on the circuit. But it completely messes him up, and Kodua has to back off completely on that hairpin so he doesn't hit Korpinski as they go through, putting him on the wrong line and creating that gap between both of the drivers. So I think the judges are going to weigh the Korpinski, was he straight enough for a zero? I'd say he's very much so. I think he's probably four wheels straight for a number of seconds there, and Kodua are making evasive action. So they're going to check that. I can tell that there's a different replay system for our judges than what you guys see at home, and they are at the moment, because I can look over the shoulder, analyzing how long he was straight for to make a clinical decision on that. But remember, the technical regulations in this championship and the technicality of the judging is the best in the world. They do not miss anything. We miss it. Sometimes the fans back home miss it, but they miss nothing. And that's why we have them there, to make sure that every battle is as fair as possible. And Korpinski there, unfortunately for him, he'll know straight away when he's steering the car straight through that corner that this is not a good place to be. Kodua will have watched an S14 come at him so fast, he had to make huge evasive action on the angle to avoid it. I think he's going in here with a massive advantage, just got to get a clean lead run under his belt. And we'll see him go through to the top 16, but don't count on anything yet because it's a long, unpredictable circuit. Here we go.
Well, there we go. Kodua to lead out Korpinski. Korpinski knows he's on the back foot here. He has to do some damage. Kodua throws a smoke signal up in his face. And Kodua has an absolutely beautiful line down this long first corner into this hairpin. Look at this on throttle. Absolutely nailed. His Kodua just does a little wheel hop on the curb there. Gets it dialed in. Korpinski starts to look for the side of that green BMW as they transition back. Kodua absolutely smoking out the PS Racing Center here in Grindback as they transition back. Korpinski almost puts himself off circuit as Korpinski desperate to try and claw some points back. Korpinski gets himself once again in the danger area, makes another mistake as Kodua puts the foot to the floor across the line. Korpinski on the back bumper.
He tried everything, Korpinski, there. He did everything within his power to try and get back into that battle. I think he's had another straighten in the middle of the circuit as well. I think that car probably too gripped up. Through the first corner, you can see he's throwing the kitchen sink at it here, trying to get back into the battle. Kodua doing a good job. Watch this line from Kodua. Absolutely perfect. And he gets that inner zone and just fires through that first corner, looking very confident. And you know, one of the better chase runs we've seen so far from Korpinski at this point. However, in my opinion, another mistake from Korpinski counts him out of this battle as well. As they transition through, he transitions a little early, goes on the inside of the circuit. Watch the next 5 seconds. Korpinski transitions, watch this, front of the car. Oh, wobble there. Almost on no angle as he comes into that last corner, and I think that's going to be seen as a mistake from the judges.
But Kodua is off that line though, Dave.
Yeah, true.
He is, you know, very close to the inside of the circuit there. We've heard it before.
Yeah. To be fair, I think you weigh it up.
Yeah, I still think there's enough in it for Kodua.
I think Kodua, I mean, you look at the straighten from Korpinski, yeah. I think you're going to have to say that's the biggest error of the two runs. I don't think that's going to be overturned by anything that happened in the second half of the battle.
I mean,
let's see which way it goes. Will it be the Georgian driver, Nodu Kodua? And it is Kodua who goes through to the top 16, and he is, look at him, he's ecstatic. He hasn't had so many great days here at Driftmasters. Well, this is starting to become a very great day, and of course...